We all know, but still pay insufficient attention to the frightening scenario of a comprehensive cyber attack, which would bring to a complete halt to the power supply, transportation, hospital services, our society as a whole. The COVID-19 crisis would be seen in this respect as a small disturbance in comparison to a major cyber attack.
Well, listen up! There is a storm coming! Like nothing you have ever seen! And not a one of you is prepared for it!
It is going down.
Catherine?
Well, mine's a little dark. I just feel a lot of concern that 2024 may be the year of a black swan event. This is a national security event with high impact that's very hard to predict. There are a number of concerns that I have that factor into that. Not only this sort of enduring heightened threat level that we're facing, the wars in Israel, also Ukraine. And we're so divided in this country in ways that we haven't seen before. And I think that just creates fertile ground for our adversaries like North Korea, China, and Iran. And that's what concerns me most.
And the last factor I want to mention is resilience, the capability to bounce back, because there will be certainly what we call the black swans, the unpleasant surprises which will come in our way.
Since our last meeting, we've made tremendous progress. And I'd like to say that most of the credit goes to our extremely efficient International Research and Development Committee. So I would like to thank each and every one of you for your hard work and dedication to our cause. In reviewing this year's progress, let me say that we have been highly effective in conditioning the people's minds to accept our solution to the world's problems. The energy crisis here in the United States was exceptionally successful worldwide, and we expect similar success with our upcoming food shortage. Our labor leaders have made great progress by causing confusion and work stoppages in all areas of the world. Financially, the dollar is being devalued even faster than we could have hoped. Politically, the public has lost total confidence in any form of government. The threat of universal war is a daily possibility. As you know, we ourselves do not need to hold any visible office of leadership. As a matter of fact, it's better that we do not. If we control the finances, news media, food, transportation, energy, we control everything. It is important that you, as world leaders, keep our program before your countrymen. With our World Bank and computer program operational, we now have the capacity to control the financial affairs of every human being on Earth by giving each person his own computer number. Anytime his number is used, we would know his financial situation at once. He could not buy or sell anything without his computer number. It will simplify their lifestyles tremendously. The end result will be a one-world monetary and government system that we alone will control.
Let me assure Americans that all FDIC-insured deposits are 100% safe and sound.
Are you sure this place is safe?
Of course it is.
Hugh Evans.
I take it you met your renter, Alonso.
It's still your money. It will always be your money. You just can't have it right now.
Miren, la televisión.
My fellow Americans, this afternoon, as many of you already know, we had an unprecedented and cowardly attack. We must remain
quiet. You know what the hell's going on here.
A state government has been developing a secret cyber warfare program for years.
China.
We've borrowed trillions of dollars from China over the last decade to keep our economy afloat. Now theirs is in trouble. My guess is they tried to collect and we couldn't pay.
Where's your citizen freedom band? No wristbands, no supplies.
Every plane, every piece of communication equipment, every GPS unit frozen except for maybe some of the very old devices.
How?
They've set the clock back 50 years for us.
Come in, Phil.
We can't stay here.
You stay. I go.
We've lost everything.
Not everything.
It's going to get worse out there. There's a bunker about 40 miles from here that we should get to.
This looks like war. You agree? We've got a decision to make.
If I can only get a hold of Phil somehow. Everybody get inside. Now!
We had to set back the clock. Reboot the system. You have to reboot the system when the system is crashing.
You're running out of time, dude.
No! Let me go!
Help me!
Get your hands off me!
Welcome, new citizen.
Did you think that this country's multi-trillion dollar debt was just gonna go away?
Thank you.
Digital connections are embedded in our homes, our workplaces, and through operational technology, our critical infrastructure. This connectivity has allowed us to realize incredible efficiency even in a world where we worked remotely. It is not an overstatement to say that it has enabled us to continue to function during a time of unprecedented crisis.
Every pure intention ends when the good times start. Falling over everything to reach the first time spark. We started under neon lights and then it all got dark. And then it all got dark.
The implication is clear. A lack of cybersecurity has become a clear and immediate danger to our society worldwide. We have seen in the past few months, for example, ransomware attacks targeting hospitals, critical infrastructure, school systems, the power grid, and many other essential services.
The text message, "Goodbye World," has been received by over a million cell phones, and many of those phones have actually shut down because of the sheer number of messages they're receiving. The source of the virus is still a mystery at this point, but as you can imagine, authorities now are looking into it, hopefully trying to pinpoint exactly where it's coming from. When we come back, we'll have our own tech experts weigh in on this and hopefully shine some light on the mystery. Also, we'll have more on the controversial decision by the Supreme Court concerning life sentences for minors. All of that, plus news updates and your weather and sports when we come back. Now we're receiving unconfirmed reports that the nation is under a large-scale cyber attack. I'm told it's suspected of being connected to that "Goodbye World" text. There have been disruptions in basic utility service around the country in some of the larger urban areas, including New York, Chicago, Boston, and...
And as soon as these people disappeared, for a lack of words, wherever they went, mass hysteria began to hit the earth. People had the appearance of absolute despair, hysteria. There was pandemonium everywhere. There was mass chaos, lawlessness, and fear was working everywhere. I was able again to see in many quadrants of the earth, and there wasn't any one nation that was under this. All of the globe was experiencing this. It was a very, very unusual instance that happened. In the dream, I wasn't able always to perceive what was going on, and yet I was still struggling with my mind during the dream. I don't know if you've ever had dreams where you were dreaming things, but in your mind you were very much aware that you were dreaming, and it was almost kind of like you were two people. You know what I mean? It's like you were almost divided. I was seeing the dream happening, and yet in my mind, I was really not wanting to be a part of this dream. But I, to be very frank with you, I had no choice as this dream was unfolding. And by the way, it lasted the whole night with the interruption at about 3 o'clock in the morning. I had no control to come out of this dream. One of the things that was happening during this hysteria was many, many peoples were asking, where did these people go? What happened? And all the globe saw this event. or they experienced it afterwards. What I saw in people was that literally nearly everyone I experienced had a great, great look of despair and hopelessness upon their face. Everywhere I went, there was hopelessness. Nobody seemed to be happy about living. You know, I've never experienced that. I've been to a lot of public places where people are bummed out, not happy, not doing well, but not the globe in masses. I don't know, maybe you've seen that. I haven't. So this hysteria brought a complete hopelessness and total perplexity to just about everyone. The television communications were down for a period of time. Again, people have asked me, well, what do you think caused that? I'm really not positive, but I would like to put something on the overhead tonight to show you an article. And for many of you Prophecy Club folks here tonight, this isn't new information to you. For some of the visitors that might be here, this may be very new information. This was an article. Let me move this down just a hair. This was an article that was given to me 2 weeks before this tour started. Let me share with you a few details. I did not want to take this tour, okay? I really did not want to connect to the Prophecy Club. When I got the prophecy for them, the Lord had told me some things about this ministry and how everything they were saying was about the end times. And I'm thinking, no, I don't want to go there. I've been booted out of enough churches. I've been persecuted enough for my position. I'm not going to hook up with anybody that's going to just completely declare the end as they really believe it. Now, you know, all of us have to leave the fear of man sooner or later in our lives. Amen? So that's what I had to do. And when I was praying about this tour, the Lord said He would give me daily a sign everywhere I went, a sign in the natural that what I had seen was truly Him. We walked in the airport today. We were coming through the terminal, and He showed me a Humvee sitting in the main area of the terminal of this airport. And by the way, it was the exact type that I saw. The one that I'm going to show you tonight on the overheads later, it's not the same one. This article was a reprint. Actually, I have the original copy if you would like it. I can get it to Prophecy Club, and you could request that. They'll, you know, get it to you. This was in the 1991 Santa Barbara, California News Press paper. This has to do with a single high-altitude nuclear blast by a rogue nation, which would bombard the continental United States with electromagnetic rays, crippling civil and military electronics from light bulbs to computers. Military experts warned Congress Wednesday. Such an explosion would unleash electromagnetic pulse. I'm going to move this up just a hair. Would release an electromagnetic pulse that would erase computer data in banks, stock market, halt cars, trucks, shut down electricity in the lower 48 states. This is interesting to me because I prophesied a long time ago that Alaska would not experience the judgment that the 48 states would receive. I got this paper and I thought, oh, that's interesting. The pulse would last only a fraction of a second. Our civilian telephone, electricity, communications, and electronic plants are all naked to our nuclear-armed enemies, said Lowell Wood, a physicist with the Lawrence Livermore Laboratories. Even a modest single explosion EMP attack on the U.S. would likely devastate us as a modern post-industrial nation. I'll move this up just again a bit. Any nuclear-capable nation, including Russia, China, and North Korea. I'm going to talk to you tonight about North Korea, some specifics. I have some inside information that the Lord has allowed me to see about North Korea and China. Any nuclear-capable nation, including these nations, could cripple the U.S. military machine and lay waste to modern American civilization, said Wood, who also is a consultant to the Defense Department. Again, that's an article from the 1991 Santa Barbara News Press. How many folks here tonight already know about that? Okay. Some things that we learn in the natural. Other things we learn in the spirit. Much of what I've learned about end time revelation has been in the prayer closet. I haven't got to go into government strategic positions and things like that except in the spirit. And so I'm actually quite excited that God is showing me some things that other men have got to be a part of by being strategically placed. This shutdown alarmed all of the peoples, and it lasted for about 2 weeks. Can you imagine briefly tonight all of your communications, your telephone, computers, television, and radio being shut down for a two-week period of time? Can you imagine the hysteria? Can you imagine, you know, the inability for a supermarket to contact its suppliers to get more supplies or gasoline or transactions? I mean, it's amazing when you begin to see it kind of unfold, the depth. This lasted about 2 weeks. Again, I want to remind you, I was not a prophecy studier or expert at this time when this vision came to me. I began to walk the streets in shock at the current events. The events are difficult to describe because lawlessness and fear was permeating society completely. After about 2 weeks of time, television and radio began to be back up and running. However, it was completely different than what was previously being broadcast. The broadcasts were being bombarded nearly everywhere, and they were depicting a soon-to-come new government and leadership. A man would be emerging to lead us. The man finally came on the scene, and he spoke with great eloquence. I wrote these things down exactly as I saw them. He spoke with great eloquence and charisma. He was soothing and promised answers to all current issues. This man was smooth and extremely convincing, able to solve nearly all problems. He was the consummate communicator, and he explained how this removal of people was God's judgment upon them. This rattled me in the dream. I did not understand his position. Let me tell you so you can kind of comprehend where I'm coming from. Not being a born-again Christian in the dream, when this man spoke, it began to convince me. It began to pull me in to the messages. I don't know if any of you have seen old films of Adolf Hitler speaking to the masses, but he had a demonic charisma about him that would literally pull the masses to him. That was nothing compared to what I saw. Nothing. He was able to rally a nation. This individual was rallying the globe. It was very, very frightening. Almost immediately, he began to communicate through large screen televisions that were strategically placed everywhere the general populace met. Think back for me for just a few moments. 1980, 1981. Large screens televisions? No. Few pizza parlors had those projector televisions, you know, with the three different colors that would project an image, but large screen televisions weren't out, folks, and neither was 24-hour news. Everywhere the populace met, big screen televisions were pumping this message. I travel a lot all over the place, and everywhere I go where the populace meets now, they have televisions. Restaurants have them. I've been to some restaurants where you have a television right at your table, so you're keeping up with everything. Airports, everywhere you go, everywhere the populace meets, you're being bombarded with messages. This was the norm. Now, what was strange about this is that this man's speeches and directions for the whole world had to do with new times upon us as human beings, new directives for global peace, and the need to give up current citizenship for world citizenship. This man continually and constantly spoke of world order and the benefits of all men dwelling together in peace. Now, even though I was disturbed in the dream, I was also being pulled into this because it sounded very, very good. World peace sounds good until you see the cost. Let me tell you, there is no world peace until the Prince of Peace establishes his throne on this earth. That's the bottom line. No human being is going to bring peace to this earth. Only the human being who's all human, all God, is going to bring peace to this earth. That's Jesus Christ. And so I began to really think of relinquishing my citizenship, and this alarmed me greatly. Even though this was a message that pulled strongly upon me, I somehow wasn't convinced of this new order. I constantly heard the word new order, world order, and new times, but I never did hear new world order. I don't know why. You have to understand, the whole world was experiencing this despair and this this chaos that was permeating society. No one, by the way, was isolated from this. No one was hidden from this. This was engulfing the whole globe. I was able to see into different regions, into different continents, and everyone was experiencing this. It was almost as though the world had all become a third world nation, completely behind the times, with the ability to emotionally process what was going on the earth.
Listen now to these things and understand them, O servants of the Lord. Behold the word of the Lord. Receive it. Do not disbelieve what the Lord says. Behold, the calamities draw near and are not delayed. Just as a woman with child in the ninth month, when the time of her delivery draws near, has great pains about her womb for 2 or 3 days beforehand, and when the child comes forth from the womb, there will not be a moment's delay. So the calamities will not delay in coming forth upon the earth, and the world will groan and pains will seize it on every side. Hear my words, O my people, prepare for battle, and in the midst of the calamities be like strangers on the earth. Let him that sells be like one who will flee. Let him that buys be like one who will lose. Let him that does business be like one who will not make a profit. And let him that builds a house be like one who will not live in it. Let him that sows be like one who will not reap. So also him that prunes the vines, like one who will not gather the grapes. Them that marry, like those who will have no children, and them that do not marry, like those who are widowed. Because those who labor, labor in vain. For strangers shall gather their fruits, and plunder their goods, and overthrow their houses, and take their children captive. For in captivity and famine they will beget their children. Those who conduct business do it only to be plundered. The more they adorn their cities, their houses and possessions, and their persons, the more angry I will be with them for their sins, says the Lord.
Like as a woman with child that draweth near the time of her delivery is in pain and crieth out in her pangs, so have we been in thy sight, O Lord. We have been with child. We have been in pain. We have, as it were, brought forth wind. We have not wrought any deliverance in the earth, neither have the inhabitants of the world fallen. Thy dead men shall live. Together with my dead body shall they arise. Awake and sing, ye that dwell in dust. For thy dew is as the dew of herbs, and the earth shall cast out the dead. Come, my people, enter thou into thy chambers, and shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself, as it were, for a little moment, until the indignation be overpast. For behold, the Lord cometh out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. The earth also shall disclose her blood and shall no more cover her slain.
I answered and said, O Sovereign Lord, if I have found favor in thy sight, show thy servant the end of thy signs, which thou didst show me in part on a previous night. He answered and said to me, Rise to your feet and you will hear a full, resounding voice. And if the place where you are standing is greatly shaken while the voice is speaking, do not be terrified, because the word concerns the end, and the foundations of the earth will understand that the speech concerns them. They will tremble and be shaken, for they know that their end must be changed. When I heard this, I rose to my feet and listened. And behold, a voice was speaking, and its sound was like the sound of many waters. And it said, Behold, the days are coming, and it shall be that when I draw near to visit the inhabitants of the earth, and when I require from the doers of iniquity the penalty of their iniquity, and when the humiliation of Zion is complete, and when the seal is placed upon the age which is about to pass away, then I will show these signs. The book shall be opened before the firmament, and all shall see it together. Infants a year old shall speak with their voices, and women with child shall give birth to premature children at 3 and 4 months, and these shall live and dance. Sown places shall suddenly appear unsown, and full storehouses shall suddenly be found to be empty. And the trumpet shall sound aloud, and when all hear it, they shall suddenly be terrified. At that time friends shall make war on friends like enemies, and the earth and those who inhabit it shall be terrified, and the springs of the fountains shall stand still, so that for 3 hours they shall not flow. And it shall be that whoever remains after all that I have foretold to you shall himself be saved, and shall see my salvation and the end of my world. And they shall see the men who were taken up, who from their birth have not tasted death, and the heart of the earth's inhabitants shall be changed, and converted to a different spirit. For evil shall be blotted out, and deceit shall be quenched. Faithfulness shall flourish, and corruption shall be overcome, and the truth which has been so long without fruit shall be revealed.
Thus he said, The fourth beast shall be the fourth kingdom upon earth, which shall be diverse from all kingdoms, and shall devour the whole earth, and shall tread it down and break it in pieces. And the 10 horns out of this kingdom are 10 kings that shall arise, and another shall rise after them. And he shall be diverse from the first, and he shall subdue 3 kings. And he shall speak great words against the Most High, and shall wear out the saints of the Most High, and think to change times and laws. And they shall be given into his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time. But the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume and to destroy it unto the end. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. and all dominions shall serve and obey him. Then shall the Lord go forth and fight against those nations as when he fought in the day of battle. And his feet shall stand in that day upon the Mount of Olives, which is before Jerusalem on the east. And the Mount of Olives shall cleave in the midst thereof toward the east and toward the west. And there shall be a very great valley. And half of the mountain shall remove toward the north, and half of it toward the south. And ye shall flee to the valley of the mountains. For the valley of the mountains shall reach unto Azal. Yea, ye shall flee, like as ye fled from before the earthquake in the days of Uzziah king of Judah. And the Lord my God shall come, and all the saints with thee. And it shall come to pass in that day that the light shall not be clear, nor dark. But it shall be one day which shall be known to the Lord, not day nor night. But it shall come to pass that at evening time it shall be light. And it shall be in that day that living waters shall go out from Jerusalem, half of them toward the former sea, and half of them toward the hinder sea. In summer and in winter shall it be. And the Lord shall be king over all the earth. In that day shall there be one Lord, and his name one. And I saw heaven opened, and behold, a white horse. And he that sat upon him was called Faithful and True. And in righteousness he doth judge and make war. His eyes were as a flame of fire, and on his head were many crowns, and he had a name written that no man knew but he himself. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. And out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that with it he should smite the nations. And he shall rule them with a rod of iron. And he treadeth the winepress of the fierceness and wrath of Almighty God. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And I saw an angel come down from heaven, having the key of the bottomless pit and a great chain in his hand. And he laid hold on the dragon, that old serpent which is the devil and Satan, and bound him 1,000 years, and cast him into the bottomless pit, and shut him up, and set a seal upon him, that he should deceive the nations no more till 1,000 years should be fulfilled. And after that he must be loosed a little season. And I saw thrones, and they sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Jesus and for the word of God, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads or in their hands. And they lived and reigned with Christ 1,000 years. But the rest of the dead lived not again until 1,000 years were finished. This is the first resurrection. Blessed and holy is he that hath part in the first resurrection. On such the second death hath no power. But they shall be priests of God and of Christ, and shall reign with him 1,000 years.